Continuing in the second lecture of unit 3, in the first lecture of unit 3 we have seen what is job evaluation, why we have done this job evaluation, what is evaluation is all about in this, why we are doing it. So we have seen that thing and many of the definitions of various standards across the universe, what they have said about job evaluation. Today we'll continue with the job evaluation's objective, advantages, few drawbacks are there, and then we'll carry out with the procedure to implement how to implement this job evaluation. So first of all, we'll see what are all the objectives for that we are doing this job evaluation. You know, there are certain number of factors, yeah, rather I should say n number of factors through which we can, certain number of factors we need to assume. Actually there are various factors, but we need to, you know, assume certain number of factors which are exactly applicable to our type of industry, because in different types of industries things are variable. So we need to, you know, assume those number of factors. Now those number of factors through which we can, you know, assess the job values, and it also varies from one job to another job inside the industry, our own plant or industry itself. So we need to take care of many things. First of all, we must have a standard procedure with us, to get the relative worth of a particular job. Okay, then we should be, you know, able to bifurcate the salaries of one job to another job, because rather I should say that is kind of a scale difference. So if one has joined to level one, and what will be the roles and responsibilities of level two then, and what should be the salary differences or the scale differences between the two levels, that is really required. That gives a platform for organization and employee both to scale themselves. And next is, like, there should not be any discrimination or differences in the wages for the same position. That is what exactly all about the inequalities, if any, if exist any. It's like it happens many of the times that a person under you know, you like him very much for many of the reasons, that he works very nicely, he obey you very nicely, he says yes in your in every in all the statement of yours. So it happens, and these are the points. It may happen that you may admire him or give him the first preference. So there can be many people who can do this, because there are many leaders across the organization who lead a group of people or a team or a department. So if this happens, then there may be the people who is a yes man of yours will be very happy, but the person who is really working very hard but is not that much yes man of yours may feel, you know, maybe surrounds with the negative vibes. So this inequality should not be there. This will definitely harm the atmosphere of the organization where we are actually, or any person are working actually. Next is, qualified workers should get corresponding wages for their respective work. Everybody, whosoever is coming to any organization, they are basically coming to earn money, and good amount of money, and it should be the proportional as per the effort made by that person, because the more he worked, the more he should get. This should be the formula inside the industry from the HR side, because we are there in an organization to earn more and more, And inside the motivational story or motivational theory, if we see across the universe, the motivational theory monetary points are coming at fourth place. But here in Indian context, if we see the motivational theory, the salary part or the monetary part comes at first place. Because what is exactly the mentality behind is one who is serving any particular organization is assumed that I am responsible towards my parents, my family, that is wife and kids. If I am able to bring out a good or handsome amount for them, then I am really working good, or usko usme enjoyment milta hai, maza aata hai. This is basically Indian mentality. So if jo corresponding work hai uske against usko wages ya salaries proper milengi, to ek to wo motivationally up rahega hamesha. Plus the way he is serving his family, he'll be happy enough. And if he is happy, then his motivation definitely pay back to the industry or the organization where he is working actually. And that way he'll grow in both the aspects at his home and as well as his job front. So for that there should be a basis or ground or table sort of for the fixation of incentives, bonuses, etc. timely without asking. If the time comes, then organization should distribute the salaries, wages, incentives, bonuses. So this keep on maintaining the morale of a worker or into of a worker to work hard, because he is going to get a good handsome amount, good and or handsome amount for his family or for his dependents. Okay, the next is one should also listen the grievances or any point coming inside in the mind of an employee or a worker or a labor. One should be able to listen it patiently and about any salary, wage, or any system, any inequality, if he feels so, then one should be able to listen the same. Okay. You should have a proper information, proper supply of information, which should be available inside the organization about the working, selection, placement, training, and many other type of things. It should have proper information. Even for a new person, if he is joining inside the organization or a person who is into the organization, he should know, or one whosoever, jo boss hai, boss should also know, or the employee should also know, whosoever is working under that boss, all should know what will be the working profile of mine, how I'll be selected for a particular project. Because inside the industry also, whether to keep you on that project or not is quite important. So you will be keeping placed for a nice and good project, then it gives you the kind of a ek into alag se milta hai. And kab kaisi kaisi kis kis cheez ke liye naye naye projects mein aapko training milegi, these all should be tabled out somewhere, taki one should see it clearly, or rather I should say transparency ho. This is again a point of a motivation कि मुझे नई चीज सीखने को मिलेगी. आई एम सिलेक्टेड फॉर द प्रोजेक्ट, इट केम इन इंडस्ट्री, और मुझे उस प्रोजेक्ट के लिए लिया गया, मुझे सिलेक्ट किया गया, मुझे इस जगह प्लेस किया गया है. पैसों के अलावा ये चीज भी काफी इम्पोर्टेंट, मुझे नई ट्रेनिंग दी जा रही है, पैसों के अलावा एम्प्लॉय को मोरल और इनको बढ़ाने के लिए ये चीजें भी काफी इम्पोर्टेंट होती हैं। एंड ऑल्सो यू नो व्हेन एनी न्यू एंट्रेंट और एनी ओल्ड एम्प्लॉय इज इनटू योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन देन इट शुड बी प्रॉपरली टेबल्ड इनटू द बॉस इनटू द टेबल ऑफ अ बॉस दैट इस बंदे का मेरे को अपलिफ्टमेंट कैसे करना है। तो एक प्रॉपर प्रोसीजर उसके अपलिफ्टमेंट का होना चाहिए ऑफ हिज और हर कैरियर इनसाइड द इंडस्ट्री और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, जिससे वो हमेशा मोटिवेटेड फील करे और जो कंपनी का आउटपुट है वो हमेशा उसको बेस्ट मिलता रहे, कंपनी को उसका आउटपुट भी बेस्ट मिलता रहे। नाउ व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस व्हाई वी आर एग्जैक्टली डूइंग जॉब एंड जॉब इवैल्यूएशन एंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली वी आर गेटिंग। सो व्हाट इज बेसिकली जॉब इवैल्यूएशन, एडवांटेज ऑफ जॉब इवैल्यूएशन इज इट्स अ प्रोसेस which should have a proper logic and technique to handle, and definitely it has a proper logic and technique to handle, which helps in developing a chart or a table for a uniform wage or salary structure, which will definitely be dependent upon relative study we have done in the previous or the priorly already done for various jobs inside the industry. Now we need to because of this we will be able to eliminate the differences in the wages or salaries across the organization, and also it helps to reduce the conflict between the employees or worker or laborers, staff, and definitely will increase the transparency across the organization, which would increase the harmony part. Next is, it will definitely give a basis for smooth administration and a proper execution in providing the wage rates. For new entrants, we should have a chart or a wage which helps to establish the person in a proper slot of a chart. Now, when a new entrant comes into, one should be able to showcase after entering into the system, you will be getting this slot to work with, and afterwards this way you will proceed ahead in the table. And similarly, a person who is inside the organization who is recruiting the new entrants should also know this type of things. I mean, it should be proper floated or flow of information inside the organization also. Okay. Next is the information definitely helps to select, transfer and promote on higher job elements basically or job levels. Basically, a person who is inside the industry can be easily selected or get it transferred or promoted to some new assignments also. It happens inside the industry whenever vacancy appears. Then what happens, HR people used to float it inside the industry or organization itself, and first of all they will try to search it out inside the industry. If it is possible, they will pick a person from industry itself, because that person knows the industry or the product or the intricacy of the product very well. But if you'll pick it from outside, there must be chances that you won't get a person of your expectation, and so this is the case. That's why they are floating first of all vacancy inside the plant itself, inside the organization itself. Then it will definitely give you the rate. It will definitely rate the jobs, not the performers. It does not rate the performers, that is worker or labor whomsoever you have done the job evaluation. It just compare or get the relative worth of the jobs only inside the organization, because there are number of workers organization has large number of workers and you know to determine proper wage and salary structure is much needed thing, and that is why it happens. Because if we go person to person, there are many factors which are different in many people. So you cannot compare it with performers. You can compare with whom. We are comparing here in job roles only. Now coming to drawbacks of evaluation system, many factors are there which arise the drawbacks of job evaluation, as well as I discussed with you one point already, that of human variability, that human every human has certain positive and certain less positive things. तो हर किसी में वही पॉजिटिव होगा, क्योंकि मुझे तो वही चीज चाहिए हर किसी से, बीइंग एन सुपरवाइजर ऑफ दैट वर्क, और तो मुझे तो वही चाहिए उसमें से. लेकिन हर बंदे का, हर ह्यूमन का फैक्टर और पॉजिटिव आर डिफरेंट. सो इट हैपेंस कि यू मे नॉट गेट एवरी द सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग फ्रॉम एवरी पर्सन. So you know some factors cannot be measured accurately, like human error accurately. There can you know you we cannot make it on high precision side, or absolute figures we cannot get it in terms of human behavior. And the next is weaker section should be rated very high. Weaker sections are has to be paid very high. As per the market requirement is concerned, or evaluated against the market, like class 4 or class 3, because they are basically the spine or backbone of the industry, and what they do is the base of any organization of industry. And on top of it, skillful people do that thing, because स्किल को रेट करना इट्स नॉट दैट इजी. बट द काइंड ऑफ रिपीटेटिव वर्क व्हिच क्लास 4 और क्लास 3 डज एंड कैन बी रेटेड अ बिट. ओके, नाउ कमिंग नेक्स्ट, इट इज नॉट सूटेबल फॉर अ यस दैट्स व्हाट आई वाज डिस्कसिंग. इट इज नॉट सूटेबल फॉर अ मैनेजर मैनेजरियल रैंक्स, बिकॉज वी नीड स्किल सेट्स. And which is not at all applicable for the labor or workers only, because at managerial level or higher than managerial level, we need skill of getting a job done or meeting the target. So handling a team of a good number of people or a big number of people requires this special type of skill. Another skills are also there. From manager position and ahead. Now next is frequent change in job condition or work condition. It also does not fit into the current table, because we know kind of a production, teen tarah ke production hote hain, job production, batch production, mass production. So if a company deals with batch production or job production, then every job is specific to that job production company. Every job has different specification. Different kind of process, different kind of methods. So at every so there won't be much repetitive work in that. So after every work, you need to change your guidelines, you need to change the training part, you need to change the focus part also. This kind of batch or job production where job condition and work condition varies, you cannot assure the current table applicability. And the next and last one, it may happen it may sometimes lead to frequently changes in wage or salary structure due to outside factors like material, method, machine. Sometimes it happens, like material is very fluctuating, prices of material are very fluctuating, and some other problems may arise. Or a company like project company, it's dependent upon core project work only. So if say projects are there for 6 to 8 months only inside the industry, then even then we cannot apply this kind of method. Sometimes there may be intermittent application of the same tables which have arise and discussed in job evaluation. Sometimes it may happens like project hai hi nahi. People used to sit at bench. So incentives ki baat hum nahi kar sakte, bonuses ki baat hum nahi kar sakte, because at that time revenue may come down. Like in this condition also, corona condition, revenue has come down. So apart from corona also, sometimes it happens those industries who are dependent upon from outside work or you know customer specific work. So kabhi-kabhi ye hota hai ki projects nahi milte jisme ye cheez applicability karana bahut mushkil hota hai. Then we have completed our drawback part. Then we'll move to procedure of job evaluation. Now this procedure of job evaluation, we have seen a glimpse in the last lecture itself. It has 8 points to discuss. First one is choose the scheme, then plan the program, then analyze the jobs. The analysis comes from internal and external evaluation. Then go to the design structure. Then seventh one is grade the jobs, and finally develop and maintain the procedures applied. First one is preliminary stage. The preliminary stage, we have to choose the scheme. For that scheme, we require the whether we have to apply a new setup or a new program, or we need to revise the existing one. Okay, so this we should know in our organization what exactly we need to deal with. Next stage is planning stage. The planning stage is evaluation program is drawn up and the job holders to be affected are informed. Planning stage mein job kin kin ke beech mein hoga, kin kin do department, teen department kaun se coordinate karenge, kahan kahan se coordination hoga, aur sample of jobs kin kin ko evaluate karna hai, wo sari cheezon pe discuss hoke finalization hoga. Then comes the analysis stage. Excuse me. This is the stage where we require information about the sample of jobs to be collected. There can be analysis stage can be from inside the industry itself or outside the, aur kis tarah ke kaam ko anjaam dena hai jise main kahun, aur kya kya information mujhe usme se collect karni hai, wo analysis stage mein aata hai. Then यहाँ दो तरह के analysis हैं, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया internal analysis है और external analysis है. External analysis का मतलब है outside the boundary of organization, that is market rates वगैरह क्या है, raw material के prices क्या है, बहुत सारी चीजें और आ सकती हैं इसमें. और internal evaluation system में ये है कि क्या exactly planning stage पे है, प्लानिंग स्टेज पे जो है उनमें जॉब्स को कैसे ग्रेड करना है, किस बेसिस पे रेट ग्रेड करना है. मार्केट से भी डेटा लेना पड़ता है कि मार्केट में भी क्या चल रहा है, और आपस में जॉब्स को कैसे डिफरेंशिएट करें, जॉब रोल्स को कैसे डिफरेंशिएट करें. ये सारा होने के बाद जब जॉब रोल्स के हिसाब से हमने ग्रेड्स को अलग कर दिया, तो उसके हिसाब से हमको डिजाइन स्टेज में सैलरीज को और सैलरी स्ट्रक्चर्स को पिक करना चाहिए. सैलरी स्ट्रक्चर को पिक करके देन उसमें ग्रेड्स बनाने चाहिए, दैट एग्जीक्यूटिव ग्रेड्स, मैनेजरियल ग्रेड्स, से असिस्टेंट मैनेजर, मैनेजर ग्रेड. उसमें मैनेजरियल वन, मैनेजरियल टू, मैनेजरियल थ्री ग्रेड्स होते हैं. तो वो मैनेजरियल ग्रेड्स कौन से हैं, कैसे रहेगा वर्टिकल, एंड आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी नीड टू डेवलप and maintain the same. How to develop? Once you have finalized these things, you need to follow the same, and while following you will get some points to make it better. So that is the development part, and side by side you have to maintain the previous or the developed one, jo bhi changes hamare paas aaye. Now next, moving to wages and incentives. If we differentiate what is wages and incentives. Wages can be defined as the remuneration paid for the services rendered by the worker. So वेजेस क्या है? वेजेस वो मिनिमम अमाउंट है जो किसी बंदे से सर्विस लेने के समय हमको या तो उसको कोट करना चाहिए और कोट की हुई वैल्यू को ही हमको उसको पे करना चाहिए. दैट इज दी वेज, व्हिच इज दी मिनिमम एश्योर्ड अमाउंट पेड टू द वर्कर. ओके, और हूसोएवर इट इज फ्रॉम वेयर यू हैव रेंडर्ड द सर्विसेज. तो वेजेस जो है दो तरीके के हैं, नॉर्मल वेजेस और रियल वेजेस. Now some other wages terms used in wages, that is minimum wage, fair wage, living wage. Different classifications are there. We'll study it in deep in our next lecture. Then we'll, in next lecture we will see what are the desirable characteristics of good wage or incentive system, how we have to perform it exactly. Exactly what should be the features for this wage and incentive system. Then we'll see what is exactly an incentive. Incentive is like way beyond the your basic monetary part. Okay, and wages are what? Wages are minimum paid amount to anybody from whom you have taken the services or whosoever has served you. Then there are many types of incentives: financial, non-financial, semi-financial, individual incentive schemes or group incentive schemes. Many schemes are there. Then we'll see the methods. Many authors like Taylor, Merrick and all has given many piece rate systems, single piece rate, multi-piece rate system, through which we can, you know, give the monetary benefits if somebody is doing good performance, better performance, excellent performance, how you can rate. So we have to finalize a base rate, and on top of it, if somebody is performing good, say number of articles they are making it in, at the desired level of accuracy, if they are touching the target level, they'll get this much. If they are enhancing the target level, then they will get this much. So these kind of things we will see into the plans or incentive schemes available in that, those methods. So that will be discussed in our next lecture. So this was the part for today's lecture. If you have any doubt, you can definitely discuss with me. Is it okay? Shall we call it a day or?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. We'll meet by tomorrow. And moving ahead with lecture number 22. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.